Hey, horse people. So, a little rooster's out there, and there's Buddy.
So, when Buddy's up here the other day, I wish I could have got it. It was crazy. Mr. T's way back out there in a pasture. So, I put a little hay here, and I'm going to bring this hay all the way around here. And this is the path, and I'm going to drop it off to Mr. T. So, Buddy's watching me. And he's got to be first to get away. That's right. I'm talking about you. So, by the way that rooster walks, my horsey people may understand why that rooster walks that way. My neighbor says because of his spurs are long. But he just cut them before he gave them to me. But he walks like his legs are straight out in front of him. He's got a funny walk. No, now you don't want to walk because I'm talking about him. But anyway, let's watch Buddy. Let me try to shrink. All right, we're back down. So we're going to watch Buddy run around a corner here when he sees me. So I got to be holding the hay and filming. So see, Buddy's watching me. Mr. T's finally got me now. Buddy's watching me. And he'll keep watching me until I go out of sight. Because he knows if I go... If I go this way, he's gonna come over here to be first to the hay. But if I go this way, he knows I gotta get over there to. Okay, so now he's crying. He's getting frustrated. Mr. T's gonna walk over here all nice and polite. Dad's bringing me some hay. I'll just mosey on over here. My buddy will come shooting around this corner. My God, when he came around the corner the other morning, it was so freaking funny. He was bucking and crying so bad. I go, Mr. T. Oh, here he comes. Why did I miss out on his phone? Oh my goodness. It's the end of the world. So he slowed down. Yesterday he comes shooting through that damn gate. I mean, full blast. I said, he's going to end up killing himself. He's going to slip and hit the ground. He was hauling butt. Came up to me kicking and bucking and just running around me. And I should probably go get that donkey and that little cow some hay. They're like, dude, there's Mr. Donkey. He's looking pretty sad. Buddy, every time I film you, you come around calmly. When I don't have this damn camera, you act like a crazy maniac. I know. He walks through the hay. I'm going to beat him like a redheaded stepchild. See, he's disappointed. He thought it was alfalfa. He's like, damn. He gave us this crappy. All right, hang on. I'll go get you some. I'll go get you some. Don't be pacing up and down there. All right, well, crap. Sorry, gum. Our horse people. I wanted to see Buddy act like a crazy maniac, but he fooled me again. Damn horse. Messes with me every day. All right, well, in that chair. I figured I would add in because I know somebody's gonna come and say, didn't you say you should pull apart the hay? Normally, I do tear apart my hay. These flakes that I have kind of fell apart in the barn and they're barely holding together. I usually have to bring them out in a bucket. And you notice I didn't break that apart, but they are slowly, because this is grass hay, and it's so loose, that it's kind of falling apart. Now, sometimes I get tightly packed grass hay, so I have to pull that apart. But you notice these guys are still nibbling and picking up little pieces versus big pieces. So I wanted to say that before I did anything else, because I know that some, I always get people who want to drive by here, damn barn witches with no life, want to come by here. He said this before, now he's doing that, and he said that, and he doesn't take his own advice. And they're just, you know, they're right fighters that want to run around the internet and cause issues and try to confuse good information, so therefore their bad information doesn't look as stupid. Because an educated public can pick out a lie. But you know what they say, you know, a lie travels around the world before the truth has time to put his shoes on. So the horse world is full of it. But I do kind of say, I'm kind of moving that and breaking it up. Normally I would break my hay up, but because this was grass and loose, that's why I didn't go out there. Kind of, I had tennis shoes on too and it was muddy. But if it was tight, I would have just put my boots on and went out there and broke it up. but with this grass hay, they like to nibble softly and kind of pick through it like that. And again, I talk about when you have horses that are eating food like they're starving and they're just diving into it. And see how Buddy's kind of picking and choosing and smelling, and he doesn't like that, and he's moving it, and he might smell something there, and he's got to walk in it and piss me off, because that's what Buddy does. He's walking over where Mr. T's eating because he wants to get to one piece of hay that smelled better. But I mean, the good to that is he's picky, so he's not starving, and he doesn't have to eat this because he's freezing, or he doesn't have to eat this because he doesn't have anything to eat unless I feed him. And he's been waiting for 8, 10, 12, 16 hours for me to throw a flake of hay out there, and then they gorge it, and then you run around a horse where it's like, my horse colic, I always hear horses colic, you can't feed. It's not the feed. It's the way people keep and feed horses that causes colic. Sometimes it can be the feed. But, you know, you'll find one person that will have bad hay, they'll get a vet report, and then they'll publicize all this bad hay, and then all the idiots that feed wrong and keep their horses locked up and only feed once a day, when their horses colic, they'll point to that one medical article that said, see, it was the bad hay. It wasn't me. It wasn't my fault. It wasn't my lack of knowledge. It wasn't my insecurities that I wanted to keep my horses locked up and safe so I could feel important. It wasn't me that wanted to make my horses have to depend on me to feed them, and they can't make it. My horses graze. Another question I get, which I wanted to answer, is why do you feed hay when your horses have all this grass to eat? Why are you feeding hay, Rick? Because this hay they're eating is fertilized, baled hay from pastures that are grown to feed horses. So it's more nutritious. This hay they're eating probably is probably 2 years old. It's left over from a year ago. It's end up being over 2 years, because I fed some of it last winter, and I still have some. I have like two or three bales left. So it still has more nutrition than the grass out here. Now, I'm not saying the grass isn't good, and again, somebody will want to manipulate that and to say, well, see, you just said grass is better, and that's two-year-old hay, and that can't be. Listen, you freaking knuckleheads who want to freaking argue. Hay that is grown and kept out of the sun, and it's not sun bleached, and is cared for, will have more energy in 2 years than this grass that has been cut and it's winter time and it's cold. Now, I'm not saying this grass doesn't have nutrition. It has different vitamins, minerals. It keeps the horses busy. It keeps them chewing. It puts something in their belly so they're not starving. But it doesn't have the same nutritional value as this. You know, you eat burgers all the time. You're not going to have the same nutrition value if you vary from vegetables and, you know, other things. So that's what varying hay does. Horses eating slow means they're not starving. If your horse is gulping and fighting for hay, another thing I get, why your horses get along so well? Because they're not competing. Horses that don't get along are usually competing. And they're competing for several reasons. Could be lack of hay, could be hunger, could be dominance, could be new herd, changing herd, could be fighting over a mare, could be, you know, herd dynamics change. There's a lot of reasons why horses compete, but when horses compete over food, there's probably a lack of food, or horses aren't getting fed enough. If horses have enough to eat, they don't care about competing over food. But Rick, if you feed them too much, they'll get fat. And I always heard horse fast, and fast horses die. And there'll be a thousand reasons on why that little sentence of logic will try to be disproven. There's a term in police work called totality, and it's in the courts, called totality of circumstances. You do not look at a situation from one or two facts. You have to view it in whole, as in totality of the circumstances. And horses are very much totality of circumstances. The way their feet are cared, the way they're handled, the way they're kept, the way they sleep, the way they get to roam, the way they have changing herds or consistent herds. Do they have enough food or not enough food? Are they getting, you know, there's so many variables to getting horses to get along and be healthy, but people want to pick and choose what supports their ignorance. And they want to pick and choose what supports when they screw up and a horse dies or gets killed, or they send it to a trainer and a trainer kills it and they go, oh, it's the trainer's fault. No, it's your fault for not taking care. It'd be like sending your kid to school and say, oh, it's the teacher's fault for making my kid dumb. Well, that's true. It is a teacher's fault, but it's your fault for not ensuring your child gets a good education. So when your horse gets hurt at a trainer, it's your fault for not ensuring that, you know, your horse was getting good care and you weren't there for the training and you knew what kind of training it was getting. But the horse world is about the greatest place in the world to find excuses. And I was just going to do a quick one of Buddy doing it, but I'll put these two together and just make this a whole video on horsemanship and taking care of horses.
Mr. T, he had a hay, look at him, he had a hay right on top of him. He's eating part of Buddy's mane. Get him, Mr. T. He's always causing problems. Eat his mane up. Rick, you shouldn't let him eat hair because I heard that hair. Shut up, you big dummies. Totality of circumstances. Look over Mr. Romeo down there. Sometimes I bring him a little cookie. This morning he was like, dude, are you bringing me a cookie? I didn't bring any cookies this morning for him. All right, so we'll end that there.